Welcome back to Getting Started with Coda iOS. Let's have a look at the terminal. Before we begin, you should have already created at least one site to connect to. If you haven't yet, check out the first video in the Getting Started with Coda iOS series. This video will show you how to use the terminal. That's right, there's a whole terminal app built right into Coda iOS. You can enter your terminal settings for your site by tapping this pencil icon here, then Edit, then tapping over here on the Terminal tab. I suggest doing this ahead of time. Otherwise, you'll need to re-enter your SSH address, username, and password, or keys every time you want to open a new terminal session. This way, it's all set up and associated with your server, so you're good to connect whenever you need the terminal. Phew! To open a terminal session, first connect to your site, then tap this Tabs button. Now tap the plus button, then Terminal. And see? These fields are pre-populated with my server info, so I can just tap Connect. If you skipped that before, no worries. Just enter your credentials now. Now that we're connected, we can use command line to do pretty much whatever we want. And like Coda's main editor, you can change the context keys as needed. At the top, we can still see our open tabs, as well as our username and the name of the server we're connected to, with a down caret. We'll come back to that in a minute. The first terminal-specific button at the top here is for secure keys. You can see your existing keys or create a new one to allow server access. See our video Using Keys in Panic Apps for more information. The one in the middle is the Clips button. Like the main editor, you can store snippets of code that you use frequently in the terminal and sync them across devices running Coda iOS and Coda for Mac. And the last button at the top right is Eject. That will disconnect you from the remote server. There are actually several ways to do this. You could also enter the logout command, or tap the down caret next to your username, then close terminal. And while we're here, this is where you can adjust your terminal settings. You can change the encoding here. Check out all of these options. And you can switch up the color scheme if you'd like, or change your beep settings here. Choose an auditory beep, a visual beep, or disable it altogether if you don't want to be bothered. You can also toggle the switch to keep the display on while the terminal is connected. Be sure to watch the rest of the videos in this Getting Started series to become a Coda iOS expert in no time. For more information, visit panic.com.